Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let me show you how to put a background image behind your documents in Pages. So my new book, My Pages, teaches you how to use just about everything in the word processor Pages, which is the number one selling piece of software for the Mac. Now, if you've ever wanted to know how to do page layout, how to do all the things in word processing like create tables of contents, insert images, wrap text, use columns, all sorts of things, it's all in here. Let's take a look at one portion of the book where it shows you how to put a background image behind your text. So as you can see here, the information in My Pages is presented in terms of tasks that you want to perform, and then you've got steps with figures with numbers here so you can see exactly where to perform each step. So here in Chapter 8 we have a section on using an image as a background. So let's start here with Step 1, which tells you to bring an image into a word processing document. So here I've got a word processing document. It's just some text. And I'm going to drag and drop from the Finder an image. And it's just this picture here. I'm going to just stick it anywhere in the page and it will insert itself in there. Now the next step you can see is to bring up the inspector window. After that we're going to go to the wrap inspector and then change the optic placement to make it in the background. So we'll select the image here, we'll bring up the inspector, and then we'll go to the wrap inspector, which is the third one there. And then we'll change this to be in the background. You can see right away the text ignores the image and flows normally, and the image is now in the background behind the text. So the next step is to turn on background objects are selectable, which is an option we'll look at in a second, and it will make it easier to select the image for the next steps. Then we're going to use the corners of the image to stretch it over the entire page. And it's okay if some of the image actually stretches beyond the visible area. In this case, the page is a vertical page and this is a very horizontal image, so that's going to happen. So let's do that. So I've turned on background objects are selectable. Now I can select this background object and I'm going to stretch it here to fill the entire page. So I'm actually going to change the view here so I can show it all to you to 50%. So you can see the entire page now, and I can drag the corners and then position it like I want. So you can see it is going to be off the edges of the screen. That's fine, but it will fill this entire page. Now next is a suggestion. The text is hard to read as it is in our example, but you can use just image to make it lighter and easier for the black text to be seen on it. So we'll do that. We'll go to View, Show Adjust Image, and we still have that image selected there. And now we can bring the brightness on it down or up, and we'll make it kind of this faint thing. We can even adjust the contrast a little bit. So now that the text is more readable, let's increase the view to normal. And you can see now it's much easier to read that text on the background. You can adjust as necessary. Steps 9 and 10 go on to give two more suggestions. One is to turn off Make Background Object Selectable so that you can't accidentally select this background image anymore. And you can also choose to lock it, and that way you can't accidentally move that background image or change its properties. You can always unlock it later. Then finally in the book here it gives you a suggestion for how to make that background image the same for every page in your document. And in order to do that, what you would do is move it to the section master. So I can do that here if I go to Format Advanced, and it's just off the edge of what you can see there, but there's an option Move Object to Section Master. Now the interesting thing is if I scroll through my document, I can look at the next page and see that the background image is there and it's on all of the pages. So that's just one of many useful things that you can learn in my new book, My Pages. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. Want more video tutorials? Just go to MacMost.com, click on the videos link at the top of the page, and then you can view all of the hundreds of MacMost videos by category.